Hi, I'm Jamie Conklin. I'm a librarian here at Lovejoy Library. Today we're here to talk about one of the most stress-inducing parts of the research process, finding a topic. When you're going through a process of a research paper, you're going to expose yourself to a lot of new information, so why not choose a topic that interests you? To help us with this task, we're going to interview a couple of different people, and today we have Amber, who is a graduate student studying social work, to help us with this process. So Amber, you've gone through many research projects by this point in your academic career. Would you say that this process of choosing a topic has gotten any easier for you?
Yeah, it definitely has. I feel like during the second or third year of my undergraduate career, I started to notice what I was interested in terms of research. And after that, I was able to explore what type of literature exists already in either our library or other sources.
Great. Are there any words of wisdom you would like to share with undergraduate students who are struggling to find a topic?
Just be passionate, and when you go into a research project, pick something you're interested in, because if it's boring and not really fun to research, you're not going to have fun with it at all.
I think that's great advice. Thank you, Amber, for your time today. We really appreciate it.
Thank you, Jamie.
Hi, we're back to talk to a second student about topic selection. And so today, right now, we have Kelsey, who is studying English education as her major, which means that she will be helping a lot of students discover topics for their papers. Students often say that they struggle with starting their research project, that one of the hardest parts is choosing a topic. Would you say that is true of you?
Yeah, I do think that's true. One of the biggest problems is if teachers are too narrow when assigning topics, or if they're too open. And if they are too open, then it makes it really hard to narrow it down and even start the writing process at all.
Right, because you have so many options available to you.
Right.
Kelsey, can you give us one or two examples of topics that you've chosen that have worked out well? And tell us a little bit about why you think they worked out well.
As an English major, a lot of the writing I do is literature-based, and so some of the topics that I write on a lot are race and gender, and that's because they really interest me. So I think that they work out well because I really like them, and so it makes it easier to get invested and get the project done because I want it to work out well.
That's a good point. And for our final question today, I would just like to see if you had any tips that you would like to share with other students when choosing a topic.
I think it's really important to research online before you even narrow it down, and then keep a small list of things that you seem interested in and go ahead and research those just very basically, because it's going to be really hard to write a paper on stuff that doesn't have information out there. So if you pick a topic and you get really invested in it and then you find that you can't find all the sources that you need, then it's kind of pointless, or it'll be more work than it's worth. So I think keeping an open list before you narrow it down and find some information is really important. And then to make sure that you set aside time so that you're not overwhelming yourself by doing all the research and all the writing at the same time. Like, pick some hours or some days out where like, okay, I'm gonna research these days, I'm gonna write these days, and then that way you spread it out and you give yourself a little more room to work.
Kelsey, I think you've shared a lot of good points today. I think it's really important that students do choose a topic that interests them. I like your idea of doing some preliminary searching beforehand, before you invest a lot of time in a topic, and I also like your idea of setting aside dedicated time for the researching versus the writing. So I think you have a lot of good points, and I really thank you for your time today, and I think students will appreciate your advice.
Thank you.
So today we're here with Che Lemoine from the English department, and he's going to talk to us about choosing a topic. So Che, can you tell us how many years you've been at SIUE and how many papers you've graded? Ballpark figure.
I've been working at SIUE around 8 years, and the number of papers I've graded, probably in the thousands by now.
When I was reading some research on students choosing topics, I read that some students will avoid controversial issues or topics that they're interested in because they don't think their professors would necessarily agree with that topic or want them to write about it. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, what I do, I tell my students they need to pick a topic that's researchable, that's arguable, and that will give them some sort of new discovery in the process.
Right.
And sometimes they do pick controversial topics. I usually do this. I let them do almost anything, but every now and then I'll just say, I don't think you want to go down that road. You know, there's some roads you just don't want to go down because it's more trouble than it's worth.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes, maybe later on in your college career, you may want to tackle this,
mm-hmm.
but for right now, I would avoid that particular topic, but those are very rare.
Right.
Those are very rare. I think most professors, especially in the English department, the professors I know actually encourage students to get involved in topics that they think will challenge them.
Right. And one last question for you. What are some tips that you have for students who are trying to choose a topic?
First of all, I ask them to think about what they would enjoy doing research on first and foremost, because it has to be a labor of love. You're going to spend a lot of time working on it. Secondly, I ask them to explore areas in their major that they may want to learn more about, or something quite possibly that they're discussing in one of their classes. And thirdly, I try to tell them that, you know, this is going to be something that's going to stay with you a while, you know, while you're working on this. And I tell them that, you know, it has to be something that you actually feel you can do the research on. If you don't feel you can do it, then certainly don't tackle it.
Mm-hmm. And I think students do struggle with that feeling of pressure or commitment to a topic.
They do. They feel that, I get this all the time. I don't think I'll be able to find enough information on this topic. And I always tell them that I said, you know, the research paper itself is not all pure research. You know, you have your introduction, you have your background and history as you educate the reader on the particular topic, and then the researchable part is really not that much. You know, when you get right down to it, especially if you know a lot about the topic. If you're totally ignorant of the topic, then yes, you're going to have to start from the word go. Mm-hmm. But if it has something to do with your major, you actually have an interest in it already and you have some knowledge on it. So the process of getting to the conclusion where you're going to defend that, it's not that difficult.
Right, and it just takes practice.
It does take time.
Yes.
You have to put in the time. You know, students think it's going to be like in high school where you moved information from one place to another, and that was usually Wikipedia. Mm-hmm. You reworded it and called it a research paper. Well,
right.
Of course, this is a university. That's not going to happen here.
Thank you so much for your time today, Che. I think you offered a lot of good help for students, and I think they'll appreciate it.
Well, it's great being in the library with you.
Thank you. So there you have it. Great tips on how to choose a topic from three expert researchers. I'll have one more that I'd like to throw at you. If you get stuck choosing a topic or focusing your topic, ask a librarian. We have a lot of familiarity with a wide range of sources, and we've worked with many students on all sorts of topics. For some of us, I think we see life as one long, multiple-part research paper. It's a lot of fun, so don't be afraid to ask us.